Very good morning to all my dear students. I welcome you all into the Industrial Pharmacy. To the capsules, and while studying the capsules, we had gone through the definition of the capsule. We saw the definition as far as the British Pharmacopoeia is concerned. We saw that what are the materials that are to be filled into the capsule, what are the different types of the capsules, that is the hard gelatin capsules, soft gelatin capsule, and the non-gelatinous capsules. We had gone through the different sizes, their volume, and the mass that is to be loaded into the capsule. We saw the advantages of the capsules over on to that of the solid dosage form and the liquid dosage form. We had also gone through several other advantages. We also studied the different disadvantages that are associated with the capsule dosage form. Now, in order to get the capsule, what we require is the capsule shell, and inside of the capsule shell, the material, the API, the medicinal substances, these are to be loaded. And this is the schematic representation for the overall process of production of capsule shell. Note that I am talking about the capsule shell. Capsule shell, it is the outer covering inside which the medicinal substance or the API that will, or the formulation that will remains inside it, right? So this is the schematic representation for the capsule shell production. It will passes through the 5-6 different stages. The steps, these are associated with the dipping of the pin, spinning of the pins, drying of the pins, which are encoated or which are coated with the gel material of the gelatin. Then the dried gel material that is going to be stripped off, that is going to be properly cutted at a specified length, and then the body that will be joined with that of the cap in order to form a capsule. Now, while studying the capsule shell, we saw the different material, that is the gelatin and the hypermellose. There are different advantages, right? Now, the capsule shell production, right? So in order to produce the capsule shell, what we require is the substance. That substance is said to be the gelatin. Now there are two different types of gelatins, said to be the type A gelatin and the type B gelatin, right? Now type A gelatin that will be having source as an animal skin, and type B gelatin that will be having source as an animal bones. Type A that is subjected to the process of acid hydrolysis in order to produce it, and type B that will be subjected to the process of basic hydrolysis in order to get the type B gelatin. So there are two different main types of the gelatin, type A and the type B, and there are different grades. Now that grades, these are based on the Bloom strength. Right, Bloom strength, that is nothing but the gel forming capacity or the gel forming property of the gelatin. Now you just apply some trick in order to remember all these. What is this? This is the type A. A, isn't it? So A, that means you will be having the animal skin, isn't it? And that will be subjected to the process of acid hydrolysis. Are you getting my point? So type A gelatin that will subjected to the acid hydrolysis, and the source material is the animal skin. Type B gelatin, as it is B, so bone is the source, and basic hydrolysis, that is the process by which it is going to be subjected or it is going to be treated in order to obtain it. So that is the type A and the type B gelatin. Now as far as the evaluation of raw materials are concerned, as I told you that Bloom strength, that is the very first and most important property that will be evaluated whenever we are selecting a particular kind of gelatin material or a grade of a gelatin material. So the different evaluation tests that will consist of bloom strength, that is gelling property, viscosity, solubility, pH, chemical purity, heavy metals presence, and the microbial count. The raw material that will be tested, like say the water that is used in order to produce the gelatin gel. So the water which is to be used, that should be tested for the electrolyte content, pH values, and the microbial count. Final gelatin solution that should be tested for its viscosity, temperature, color composition, and the color shades. As far as the process of capsule shell production is concerned, that process will require strictly controlled environment. So that is the controlled manufacturing environment. So that should contain, or that should have, a controlled humidity, relative humidity, and that should not have deviation or plus or minus 0.5% variation, or the deviation that could be the acceptable. As far as temperature is concerned, again plus or minus 0.5 degrees Celsius, that will be acceptable. And as far as the air circulation is concerned, that should be 8 to 10 changes per hour. That means the air that should be replaced, and the rate of replacement that should be 8 to 10 times in an hour. The mold that will be made up of stainless steel molds, and these molds, these are known as the pins, and these are cylindrical in shape with its hemispherical end. So that hemispherical end, that is in order to give the dome shape or the curvature shape end to that of the capsules. There are 30 pins that are going to be mounted onto a metal bar in case of a this stainless steel molds. The temperature which is required for these is the 22 degrees Celsius. Now, for the process of capsule shell production, there is an optimum content of empty capsule shell of the moisture, and that should be in the range of 13 to 16% as far as the hard gelatin capsule is concerned. If it is the soft gelatin capsule, that should be in the range of 3 to 4 to 17%. The average production cycle time which is required in order to produce a capsule shell, that is the 45 minutes. Why this is 45 minutes? Because it has to go through the process of different stages, like say dipping, spinning, drying, then stripping, then cutting, then joining, right? So all that will require the 45 minutes. So these are going to be prepared shells that will go through the process of the processing. Once the capsule shells, these are produced, they will be subjected to the process of processing. Now that processing, that will consist of the sorting of the good capsules and removing the bad capsules or faulty capsules or the defective capsules or incorrectly produced capsules. Then that will be subjected to the process of printing. Now printing, that is nothing but the name of the brand, or name of the content, or the dosage strength, or the anything which is required, like say the logos, etc., etc. Then that will be subjected to the process of packaging, and then it will be subjected to the process of storage, from where that will be released for the process of the filling. So capsule shell production, it passes through the sorting. So sorting, that will passes through this schematic representation, and it, as it has been shown onto this slide, the prepared capsule shells empty, that can be taken, and that will be subjected to the process of sorting devices. Now this process of sorting, that can be carried out by different types, the different kinds of the sorting devices that can be used. We can go for using or choosing the mechanical filter, optical filter, manual filtration, and the PLC based automatic sorting devices. Once the sorting that will be done, the correct empty shells that can be collected, and the damaged empty shells that can be discarded. So Once it is going to be sorted, then the capsule shell that will be subjected to the process of printing. So printing, generally the offset printing method that is going to be used. So these are going to be printed along with the name of the API, the dose of the API, name of the manufacturer, or any other labeling or requirement in order to identify, or which will be helpful to identify the capsules. In order to print the edible ink that should be used for the capsules, the shellac based inks that are used mostly, and 40% shellac solution that is used as a ink base for the process of printing of capsule shells. The printed capsule shells that should be packed and that should be stored properly. The moisture content that is most important parameter in case of the capsule shells, because they will absorb the moisture and they will become softened, right? So that will not require. So the moisture content of the empty capsule shell, that should be in the range of 13% to 16% weight by weight. Now for every 1% change in moisture, there is a 0.5% change in the capsule shell dimension. So that's why in order to maintain the proper dimensions, proper diameter, proper length of the caps as well as bodies, there is a need to have the optimum humidity or the moisture inside of the capsule shell, that is between the 13 to 16%. This is also important in order to withstand the mechanical, sharp mechanical stress during the process of filling, because the capsules that will going to be held, so the required degree of flexibility that is going to be offered because of the presence of this 13 to 16% moisture. Now the ideal condition for the temperature, that is between the 15 degrees Celsius to the 30 degrees Celsius at which the capsules that can be stored. During the process of capsule production, some faults that may occur into the capsules, and such faulty capsules that should be rejected, that should not be selected. Now what are these faults? You can see the very first, that is the cracking or the cracked capsules. You can see there is a cracks into the cap, there is a cracks into the bodies. So body and caps that with many splits, these are said to be the cracking. There is a double cap. Double cap, you can see the capsule with the additional cap covering body. So that is said to be the double cap, double dipping. So double dipping, that will lead to the extra thick cap due to double dipping. As you can see, this is shown in a dark line. So that is the double dipping issue. Then there is a no separation. Cap and body may not separate properly. They will remain stuck with each other. Sometimes there is a chance that there is a presence of the holes because of the improper covering of the pins, so that the holes that will remain. So irregular openings that will be observed in case of the cap or body. The join in lock. You can see the locks, they will going to be joined, the capsule that is in the lock position. The long cap and body, sometimes if the desired specifications that cannot be obtained, or if the incorrect cutting that will be occur, so that will lead to this particular fault, which is said to be the long cap or body. So length of the cap or body, if it is more than 1 millimeter of the specified length, then such capsules have to be treated or to be called as the long cap or body type of faults. Pinch, you can see pinch, that is nothing but the squashed flat. So mechanically damaged portion that will lead to the pinching. Then there is a mash. Mash, that is nothing but the mash is nothing but the mechanically damaged or the squashed flat, and pinch, that is nothing but the cap or body that will be damaged in collect. And if it is more than 3 millimeter, then such should be treated as a pinch. Short body, you can see if the length of cap or body that is less than that of the specified length, if it is less than that of the 0.4 millimeter, then such capsules are to be treated or to be called as the with the short body. There are another major faults which are understood or which can be categorized as trimming, uncut cap body, unjoined, and the die spec. So trimming, that is nothing but the hole or piece of trimmed or end cap or body that will remain inside of the capsule. Uncut cap or body, so the untrimmed cap or body, or if it is not properly cutted, if it is not trimmed, then such capsules are to be treated as uncut cap or body. Unjoined, if you will going to find single cap or single body alone as such, then such are treated or such are to be called as the unjoined cap or body. Dye spec, that is nothing but the colored spot of the pigment, or sometimes the different from the cap or body color. So that is because of the improper process of drying. So that is said to be the dye spec. Some another faults, like say the short cap, if the length is less than that of the 1 minute, if the length is that is less than that of the specified length by the 1 millimeter, then such caps are said to be the short cap. Split in wall starting from cap or body edge, that is said to be the split. Telescope, the closed capsule with the protruding piece of cap or body. So that is said to be the telescoping, that is fitting one into the another completely. Then, or sometime some orientation of the cap or orientation of the body that will get changed. So instead of fitting the into the body, or instead of fitting into the cap, the body open portion, the closed portion that will get entered into the body. So that is said to be the telescoping. Thin spot, that is nothing but the shoulder, or this is the thin area that will rupture when the capsule that is going to be filled. Because of filling, the pressure that is going to be exerted, and because of the thin area that will get ruptured. So all these are the different faults that you will going to find during the process of capsule shell production into the produce the capsules. Now, how we can go for producing the capsules? There is a method which is said to be the injection molding. Now, what this injection molding is, we need to go for selection of the raw material. Of course, that is nothing but the based on the type of raw material that we are choosing. Either it is gelatin or hypermolecules or starch, whatever it will be. So the raw material that need to be selected, that will be subjected to the process of high pressure melting. Then the molten material that will be selected, that will be melted at 70 to 200 millipascal. Temperature that should be 120 degrees Celsius to 180 degrees Celsius. And that this should be below the glass transition or the melting temperature of the polymeric materials. Then the injection of molten material into the mold that should be carried out. Now these molds, they will contain the shapes similar to that of the capsules. And inside these spaces, the material that will enters, and that will be subjected to the process of cooling, and after the process of cooling, the removal of the molded part that should be carried out. So it is just a molding processes in order to produce the capsule shells. Now you can see here, this is the clear cut picture that will going to be showing the cap and the body. You can see this is the portion which is said to be the cap that is shorter one, the body that is longer one. The cap that will be having slight larger diameter, the body that will be having slight smaller diameter. So this is the internal diameter. So internal diameter is slight larger one, so that this cap that will get fitted properly or onto that of the body. So the cap that will shows the different parts, like say air vent, locking ring, pre-lock, and the cap ring. Whereas the body that will shows the body edge, locking ring, and the air vent. So what the details that we saw up till now, that we can summarize. So we saw the capsule as a dosage form. We saw the official definition for the capsule, the advantages, disadvantages over onto that of the tablet and other formulations. The process of production of the capsule shells, including the sorting, printing, and the storage of the prepared empty capsule shells. and the introduction related with that of the hard gelatin capsules. Now in continuation to that, today again we will see that what are the hard gelatin capsules, how the hard gelatin capsule filling that should be carried out, and various principle and methods of capsule filling along with the formulation principle of the hard gelatin capsule cells. So after going through the coming slides, the student that should able to explain all these things, or the student they should able to understand all these things. Now in order to understand all these things, our lesson plan that will move through the introduction to the hard gelatin capsule, the method of filling of the hard gelatin capsule, the advancements in filling of hard gelatin capsules, and the formulation aspects of the hard gelatin capsules. So what the hard gelatin capsules are, as you know that already, we know that it will consist of the two pieces of the capsules, isn't it, in which the dry powder that can be loaded. So more than 85% of the hard capsule shells, these are made up of the gelatin material, gelatin that is used. These are elegant in appearance because of their shiny polished structure, because of their color, because of the labeling, because of the printing. These are highly elegant. These are easy to swallow because of their shape, elongated shape that will be easily passed through the esophagus along with a sip of water. Medicament that is going to be protected from the external environment, which is not offered, which is not found in case of the tablet, right, because it is completely enclosed. And the release of drug that will occur at a faster rate. So the onset of action or the release that will be faster than that of the capsule in case of the tablet in case of the capsule. As far as the hard gelatin capsule is concerned, the James Murdoch, he had patented the two-piece telescoping gelatin capsule in 1847 in London. He had filled with the powder, or more normally the fillets, and he made this by process of extrusion and the spheronization. So the process by which the capsules that was produced, but this was the olden age old practice. Now it was in 1847. Nowadays the methods are totally changed. Now by placing the compressed slug of powder into one half of the capsule. So what he did, he had compressed the powdered material and he had placed it into one half of the capsule. And by filling one half of the capsule with the loose powder. Let us say, for example, in case of body, he had placed the slab, and in case of cap, he had placed the powder. With the compressed slab method, weight varies less between capsules. However, the machinery required to manufacture capsule is more complex. So hard gelatin capsule filling, the process of filling that will occur either by manual method or by mechanically or by automated. So whatever it will be, whether it is manual method or mechanical method, it has to pass through the different necessary steps, and these steps are nothing but the feeding and rectification, suppression, filling, joining, and the ejection. Feeding, that is nothing but the loading the capsules. Rectification, it is the process in which the proper orientation of the capsules that will be carried out, which means the body that should facing downward, whereas the cap that should remain at the top. Separation, it is a stage which will consist of the separating the cap from that of the body. Filling, the material which is to be filled, that is to be loaded so that the body that can be filled. Joining, the process which will involve the placing the caps over onto that of the body and then compressing so that the body that will get entered into the cap and that will get completely locked so that the leakage of the material that should not occur. And then there is an ejection. So ejection that will consist of the capsule along with the cap, body, and the loaded material. So this is the hand operated filling device. As you can see, this is the plate which will contain the capsules, the capsule that is to be loaded, and these are going to be properly oriented. Once these are going to be properly oriented, they should be locked, their body that should be locked. Whereas in case of the upper plate, there is a proper placement of the cap, the cap that will be the tray that will be lifted, so that only the cap that will get removed. And as all the capsules body, these are into the locked position, so they cannot get lifted up. Only the cap that will comes up, or only when we are going to be lifting the upper tray, so that upper tray will carry only the caps and not the body. So this is because of why? This is because of the diametric differences, because the cap that will be having the slight larger diameter, so which will ensure their removal. Then the tray has to be loaded, which is said to be the powdered tray. So the powdered material that will be loaded, and with the help of a scraper, the complete filling of the body that should be carried out. Then there is a placement of the tray that will contain the cap, and then there is a slight compression, manual compression that will be carried out, so that the cap that will be completely fitted over onto that of the body. So this is the hand operated device which is going to be used in order to fill the capsules. Now
the first step is feeding and rectification. Capsules fall by gravity into the feeding tubes or chutes, then uniform aligned by mechanically gauging the diameter differences between the cap and the body.
So you can see this is the process of rectification. Rectification, that means what? This blue colored one, that is the cap, this white color, that is the body. So you can see here all the bodies that are facing downward direction, right? So that is the rectification.
Capsules fed in proper orientation into a two section housing, or
once the proper rectification that will be carried out, the cap that will be removed from that of the body.
Bushing. The feeding and the rectification method is generally for the separation of improper or incorrect capsules from the filling or the operation. The next step is separation. The diameter of the upper bushing or the housing is larger than the
Cap that will be separated from that of the body. The body that will be folded by lower plate, and the cap that will be folded by the upper plate because of the diameter differences.
Diameter of the capsule body bush.
See, in this particular picture, you can very clearly see that the cap, these are going to be separated. So this is the particular place where the cap that cannot goes down. So because here there is a narrow diameter,
the capsule cap is retained within the upper bushing and the body is pulled into the lower bushing by vacuum. Once the capsule is opened or separated, the upper and the lower housing or bushing is separated to the position the capsule body for filling. In this process, in general, we separate the body and the cap of the capsule, and the body should be available for the filling after this process. Now, a very important step of the hard gelatin capsule filling.
So, this is the by which the process of feeding, filling and rectification that will occur along with the separation. Now, once the cap that will be separated with that of the body, the process of filling need to be carried out. And the filling that will occur through the different mechanisms by the different methods. Now, these different methods are said to be the auger fill method, mechanical vibration fill method, dosator method, tamping pin dosing disc method, and the compression fill method. Now, what these methods are, that we will see. Auger fill method, like say the auger fill It is the semi-automatic method. Now, filling is primarily volumetric. Rotating auger blade that will forces the powder through a feed shoe into the open capsule bodies. The dosing volume that can be controlled by rotation speed of the body ring, rotation speed and design or pitch of the auger and lever of powder within the drug hopper reservoir. Now, what this auger is, just try to understand that there is a powder bed, and just below there is a powder bed of certain thickness, of certain level. So this level, this thickness that will be maintained based on the material, based on the volume that is to be loaded into the capsule, right? And onto this powder bed, the material that is going to be pressed with the help of a device into the capsule body. So the body that will be held at the bottom, and from top with the help of certain device, the material that is going to be loaded. So it is the thickness, it is the level of the powder which will determine the volume and weight of material that is to be loaded into the capsule body. Is it clear?